Over the last year and a half, I've put a lot of accessories on this 2018 Honda Goldwing. So let's take a look at which ones I like, which ones I'm not crazy about, and which ones I would avoid altogether. That's coming up right now. So first, let's talk about the Honda accessories. I'm going to go through those first. And the first thing I added to this motorcycle were the wheel stripes that came from Honda. I got the red wheel stripes, and I installed those. I did a video on it. And I think they actually do improve the looks of the bike. I have a white, you know, Goldwing, obviously, and I think the red stripes look really good. I think they also make them in gray. They were fairly easy to install. You don't have to remove the wheels to put them on. The only thing I don't like about the wheel stripes is I wish they were reflective. I think that would have really added value to having the wheel stripes on the bike. So I think some other companies out there make reflective wheel stripes, and I think if I were going to do it again, I'd probably go with one of the aftermarket reflective wheel stripes just for the safety factor. The second thing I added were the upper air deflectors, or the little wings that go underneath the rear view mirrors. I've been pretty pleased with how these work. They don't block as much wind on your hands as, say, the old wings that we had on the previous model Goldwing, but they do a pretty good job, and they actually do a really good job of directing air in the summer to kind of keep you cool when it's warm outside. So they actually work better for that than they do blocking the cold air. Another one of the first things I added was this passenger audio control unit from Honda, and I'd have to say this is probably one of the biggest fails on Honda's part. Maybe I misunderstood what this product was. I thought it was going to allow my passenger to have her own audio source and to control the volume of that audio source. But in reality, all it does is give the passenger control of the motorcycle's audio system. So when she increases the volume, it increases my volume and her volume. Same thing with changing the source. It also just changes it for the whole bike. So it's really pretty useless because it's not that big of a deal for her to communicate to me that she wants to increase the volume or to change the channel or whatever on the radio station. So I don't really understand the value of this passenger audio control unit unless, as a rider, you don't listen to music, you don't listen to the audio, you're listening to something else or just nothing, and maybe your passenger wants to have control of the radio system. So, you know, to me, it was pretty useless. I also question the design of this system, the way it mounts on the top of the trunk. It just doesn't seem like a good engineering design to have electrical switches completely flat in a surface like that, especially in a little well where water can actually stand. It just doesn't seem like a good design to me. I would probably not go the route of the passenger audio control unit. To me, it was just kind of a waste. I was actually pretty excited when I saw that Honda had integrated the HomeLink system into the motorcycle so that you could open your garage door, and I think it's pretty well integrated. It works very well. I installed this. This is another one of the first things I added. I think operationally, functionally, it's a very good system. It works well. I control both of my garage doors with it. The only complaint I have is it's unnecessarily hard to install. There was absolutely no excuse that Honda did not go ahead and include those switch buttons on the motorcycle so that you don't have to take the whole bike apart to get to the console. As I was installing the HomeLink system and I had the bike all apart, I went ahead and took the front end of the bike apart to install the XM Sirius radio antenna. Again, this is another aftermarket accessory that should have just been included with the motorcycle. It's $99. I went ahead and went with Honda's XM Sirius antenna. You can buy one on Amazon, just a standard antenna that will work fine with the Honda radio. for about 15 bucks. And a lot of people have done that. So there's not really, it's not really necessary to take this all apart to install this XM antenna. But once you get it installed, it does work very well. The XM Sirius radio is very clear. It has plenty of power. It seems to have more volume than the regular radio. So it's one of the few things in the radio system that works pretty well is the XM Sirius radio. Now, I also installed the Honda LED entry lights, or the puddle lamps, some people call them. I have mixed emotions about these because they work intermittently on my motorcycle. Sometimes I walk up to the bike and they come on. Sometimes I'll walk up to the bike in the dark and they don't come on. I'd say they work about 75% of the time. I like them. I think they're a pretty cool feature. They're a little expensive like everything else. Now, if you've had problems with your LED entry lights not working all the time, put it in the comments down below. I'd like to hear your experience if anybody else is having the same issue. So let's talk about the trunk rack. I'm not a big fan of luggage racks because I don't use them. I had one on my previous Goldwing. I have one on this Goldwing, and the only reason I have one on this Goldwing is because it's a place to mount the under rack light from Pathfinder LED. Trunk rack itself to me is kind of useless. I think it has a 5-pound weight limit, so I mean, what can you really put on it? If you put anything really heavy on it, you run the risk of damaging your trunk or cracking the trunk. I wouldn't want to do that because that's not a cheap part to replace. Also, the installation of the trunk rack is suspicious. After I installed mine, my trunk lid is now in a little bit of a bind, so it doesn't close and open as easily as it used to. It kind of sticks. And I suspect it's because the holes where you drill those holes aren't perfectly matched up with the legs on the luggage rack. I've talked about this in another video. That means I'm gonna have to remove my trunk lid and kind of wallow out one of those holes and get this to all line up better so that it doesn't put that trunk lid in a bind. Because right now my trunk lid is in a bind, and I know some of you have already told me you've had the same experience with yours. And I drilled those holes exactly where Honda said to drill the holes. So I don't think it was my installation. While I was installing this trunk rack, I also went ahead and installed the interior light for the trunk, which I kind of wondered if it was really necessary, but now that I've added it, I love it. It really lights up the inside of the trunk when it's dark outside. I use it all the time. So I think that's probably one of the best things I've added is that little interior trunk light. If you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, please click that little subscribe button down below. And if you click the bell icon, YouTube will notify you when I come out with new videos. Now I'm not done. I've just done the Honda accessories. When we come back after this little annoying break, I'm going to talk to you about some of the aftermarket accessories that I've added to this 2018 Goldwing. Welcome back to Cruise Man's Garage. I'm Cruise Man, and I'm talking about the different accessories that I've added to my 2018 Goldwing, kind of giving you a quick review of some of them. I previously talked about all the accessories that came from Honda, and now I'm going to talk about some of the aftermarket accessories that I've added to the motorcycle and tested out over the last year and a half. I have four different things that I've added from Rivco. Many of you are familiar with Rivco. The first thing I added were these passenger armrests. And while they're very comfortable, very well made, everything I've ever seen from Rivco is very well engineered, very well made. The Rivco armrests, the only problem I had with them, they really just don't match the look of the bike. They're kind of an oval shape, but they're very well padded and they're very comfortable. So if you're looking for something for comfort, they're excellent. But they're just, it just kind of doesn't go with the lines of the bike. That oval shape just doesn't really fit, in my opinion. So I went ahead and removed them just for that reason. Plus, I don't ride with a passenger that often. I primarily installed them so that I could do a video for Rivco showing how to install those. Again, they're very well made, very comfortable. I like the way they swing out to allow the passenger to get on the bike. And again, everything I've had from Rivco is very well engineered like that. The next thing I had were the Rivco Aero pegs. Now these were the highway pegs that kind of mount on, you know, on the engine area. And again, very well engineered, very well thought out. Rivco's been making these for the previous generation Goldwing for some time, and now they've adapted them for the 2018 Goldwing. And I think from an engineering perspective, they're probably the best engineered highway peg that I have found. I like them. I use them on several road trips. I found them to be very comfortable. I like the fact that they're adjustable. I like the fact that if you were to drop the bike, they would either fold up or break off, preventing damage to the motorcycle. I did remove them, however, for a couple of reasons. Number one, I had to do some other installations and some other maintenance videos, and they were kind of in the way, so I had to go ahead and remove them. The only thing I don't like about them is they kind of hide that beautiful engine. And I think the engine is the centerpiece of the motorcycle, and it's really attractive. So I don't like the fact that the aero pegs kind of hide the engine. Other than that, though, functionally, as a highway peg for long-distance comfort, I think they're the best ones made right now. Now, I also tried out the Rivco fog lights. By far, the Rivcos are the brightest ones. I really, really love them. When you're going down the road, people coming toward you, if they don't see you when you have those Rivco fog lights on, then they're blind, because those things are blindingly bright to oncoming traffic. And I mean that in a good way. It really lights up the road. So if you're looking for brightness, then the Rivco is the way to go. It has its own switch, its own proprietary switch, which is fine. And in most cases, you're going to leave those on all the time anyway, so it's no big deal. The last thing I'm going to talk about from Rivco is the trailer hitch. It's a pretty intense installation job, but I love the trailer hitch. It's very well engineered. It's solid as a rock. It's got 4 points of contact on the frame, so it's very, very solid. I don't think there's a better trailer hitch out there for the 2018 Goldwing, in my opinion. I've looked at some other ones. I just don't see that they're engineered as well as the Rivco trailer hitch. I'm a big fan of the Rivco trailer hitch. I highly recommend it. If you're pulling a trailer with your 2018 Goldwing, there's no better trailer hitch than the one from Rivco. Now, let's talk about some of the things I've put on the bike from Show Chrome and Big Bike Parts. I've only put on a couple of things, but they're kind of interesting and I've been pretty impressed. The first one, and one that I consider to be an absolute must for any 2018 plus Goldwing, is the isolator fuse block. This basically lets you plug all your accessories, your electrical accessories, into this motorcycle, and it protects them from the CAN bus system, or I should say, it protects the CAN bus system from them. On this motorcycle, the electrical system is not like the old days where you can just splice into a wire or a circuit and start adding accessories. It doesn't work that way. So something like this Show Chrome isolator fuse block, I think, is a huge, huge win if you're going to be adding additional lights or LEDs or other accessories to your motorcycle. The other product I have from Show Chrome Big Bike Parts is the LED marker lights. Now, these fit on the front forks. They replace the reflectors on your front forks and on your saddlebags. And these are LED lights that also work as running lights and turn signals. When I first saw the LED marker lights from Show Chrome, I was a little suspicious because to me it looked a little gimmicky. And I'm not big on just adding LEDs to my bike just to have it look cool. But you know, once I got them installed and saw how they worked, I think they actually are a big safety feature. They work with your running lights and your turn signals. They're fairly easy to install. And I really, now I wouldn't have the bike without them. The last thing from Show Chrome Big Bike Parts is the Ultra Guard bike cover. They sent me the half cover to try out and test, and I've used it on several road trips, and I really like it. It's very well made. I think it looks good. It has nice surfaces that are soft on the windshield. I highly recommend that Ultra Guard half bike cover. Now, I think they've come out with the full bike cover now for the 2018. Give that a look too. Now let's talk about the aftermarket products I've added from Pathfinder LED. Most of you may know that I've done a lot of videos over the years for Pathfinder LED SoCal Moto Gear. I have a lot of their lights on my 2012 Goldwing. So when they started coming out with products for the 2018 Goldwing, I was very excited because I always had a good experience with the Pathfinder LED products. So the first thing I installed and tried out were their fog lights, which also include daytime running lights. Now, these are the fog lights that I currently have on my 2018 Goldwing. They do have a separate, like a little ring of DRLs around the fog lights. And honestly, I never use those by themselves. I always just leave the entire fog light DRL on at the same time. So I wouldn't have to have that feature, but it is kind of cool to have. Many of you have seen my video where I installed the multifunction LED under the luggage rack. I absolutely love that. I think it's saved my butt a couple of times already because it has a built-in modulator for the brake light. It also has a running light, and it's got the sequential turn signals. So it's really a cool, cool light. I love it. If you've got a luggage rack, that's the best light you're going to find. It's multifunction. It's got some cool features, and I'm just a big fan of that. The last thing I installed from Pathfinder LED, and the most recent thing I installed, are the LED multifunction cowl lights. When I first got these in and saw them, I thought, man, this is kind of a gimmick. But then I installed them and I saw how they work, and I'm a big fan now. They put out a lot of light and they make your bike much more visible to oncoming traffic and to traffic coming from the side, because these wrap around that fog light cover. So you get some side light and you get the front light, but they also have sequential turn signals built into them. Couldn't do a video like this without talking about my windshield from F4 Customs. I have the F4 Customs Plus 4. It's the biggest one they make for the 2018 Goldwing. And I've tested all three windshields they make for the 2018. I also really liked the 20-inch model that has the little recurve, because I thought it was actually a better looking windshield. It kind of fit the looks of the bike better. But I went ahead and went with the taller Plus 4 windshield because I just like that extra bit of protection. Now, real quick, I'm going to talk about the Garmin 595 LM. As you know, the built-in GPS on the Goldwing is junk, so I went ahead and added the Garmin 595 LM on my left handlebar, and I love it. It works great. It works like a GPS is supposed to work. And if you're looking for an external GPS, either the 395, 396, or the 595, they're both great systems. That's my review of my 2018 Plus Goldwing accessories so far. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks again for joining us on Cruise Man's Garage.